It is the next step in the Ohio River Bridges project. Today, crews started tearing down a Jefferson County home so they can begin building the East End Bridge. WLKY's Erica Coghill is here now with a look at their progress. Erica?
Yeah, Rick, finally, something that you can see moving forward and making strides in the project. Crews were out in the 7100 block of Greengate Court in East Jefferson County for demolition today. They started knocking down a home there around 7 this morning, and they planned to work until just a couple of hours ago.
The sound of stepping forward.
I just hope that they don't drag their feet. Let's get this thing over with.
It's been decades since first talks on the bridges project, and Monday, Steve Hansen got a front row seat when construction crews dug into his neighbor's former home.
And the heavy equipment rolled in, and now this morning they started knocking down the house, which for me is good to see finally.
He says the state bought his neighbor's home just about 2 years ago, and since, it's just been sitting in need of maintenance.
House has been sitting vacant, we've just been waiting.
And wreckage replaced that wait Monday. Crews began bulldozing around 7 to make way for utilities.
A lot of the utility lines that are currently in place are up against 841 right now. They're going to have to be relocated.
There are some telephone boxes along Springdale Road near the Gene Snyder at US 42. And crews say since that portion of the freeway is set to be reconstructed, those utilities will be moved here where the home once was. Transportation officials say utilities are step 3 of the 4 phases in the bridges project. They have the design and right-of-way. Step 3 utilities is the last before actual construction on the East End Bridge begins. A scene symbolizing strides.
I'm starting to believe it now. It looks like the project is definitely going to take place.
And crews will be right back at it tomorrow, cleaning up the rest of the debris from the home. They say it could take them as long as a few days to clean up the site. Erica Coghill, WLKY News.